This guy is a vile, arrogant, nasty Mohammedan. He converted, Jeffrey Lang. He's, from what I know, he's no longer active, but nasty, arrogant. I wish I had a chance to have debated him so I can bury him and his fake God by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. But anyway, you can even tell his arrogance, how nasty he comes off. Arrogant, nasty, vile. And he converted Islam. Now watch here. Now watch his attempt of explaining away the error that Mary is identified as a sister of Moses because she's said to be the sister of Aaron. Mary, the mother of Jesus in the Quran, is said to be the sister of Aaron. And I'm going to show you why that's significant, but listen to his objections.
Does the Quran have any contradiction with what history has been able to establish? Of course, you know the Muslim answer. No, they feel it doesn't. And they never felt it had. And frankly, like I said, I could only think of two examples in all the reading I've done of Orientalist literature, two real examples that they're able to come up with. Two findings that...
This guy is really a wicked, dishonest tool of Satan. He even wrote a book, Losing My Faith, where he documents that Muslims contact him saying they're losing their faith in droves. And he mentions a list of contradictions they bring up. Anyway, he is a tool of Satan. Remember, when you follow Allah, who is Satan, you're going to be a liar and deceiver and wicked and murderous. But this coward lives in the West.
Contradict history. One is sort of very weak. So let me just move time limitations wise to the strongest of them. The strongest contradiction, and this is mentioned by as great a scholar as Kenneth Craig, Montgomery Watt mentions it.
He admits it's a strong argument. A contradiction is solid if you can show there's no answer to it. He's admitting it.
Especially the clerical Western scholars mention this quite a bit. The one that they felt they found was a report in the Quran, a verse in the Quran, which has Mary's kinfolk saying to her, Mary, the mother of Jesus, peace be upon him, has Mary's kinfolk saying to her, O sister of Aaron.
He's even a terrible speaker, dude. The guy, he sounds like an effeminate, like timid.
How could you do such a thing? O sister of Aaron. And Kenneth Craig and others said, see, there is an anachronism. Because if Mary is the sister of Mary, is certainly not the sister of the prophet Aaron.
Exactly. Now watch his attempt to explain it away. And I'm going to bury his arguments. Learn it. Remember, he said this is a strong contradiction. He admits it. But he doesn't give the full argument because he's dishonest like Muhammad.
How could they? The Quran is saying they're contemporaries. And everyone knows they're not. The Muslim reaction. Nothing less than exasperation.
Okay, the Muslim reaction is what?
Sorry. Why did no one tell Arizona drivers about this new rule?
Shut your
mouth. You are currently insured.
Shut your pile. Less-
does the scholar as Kenneth Craig mention this quite a bit? The one that they felt they found was a report in the Quran, a verse in the Quran, which has Mary's kinfolk saying to her, Mary, the mother of Jesus, peace be upon him. As Mary's kinfolk saying to her, sister of Aaron.
Terrible speech.
How could you do such a
you
thing?
You suck, dude. You speak just
sister of Aaron. And Kenneth Craig and others said, see, there is an anachronism. Because if Mary is the sister of Mary, is certainly not the sister of the prophet Aaron. How could they? The Quran is saying they're contemporaries. And everyone knows they're not.
Really?
The Muslim reaction was nothing less than exasperation and fury.
Hush.
When writers would counterattack with the things that, or would read what Kenneth Craig had written. Because basically they have a good deal of respect for him. But they felt that that type of thing was below the belt and duplicitous.
What a lowlife scum. He even sounds disgustingly arrogant. And he's too stupid to be this arrogant. Duplicitous? Your God is duplicitous. He's Khairul Makareen, the greatest of all deceivers. But watch him undo to this guy. See why I don't like to watch this stuff? They make me sin in my heart. May the Lord cleanse my heart.
For the following reason. They mentioned, as many a Christian will mention, that the expressions sister, brother, daughter are used very loosely in the Middle East, like son of David.
No, not like son of David. See, this is the first lie. Let me now destroy the first lie. We're going to go in depth. He's saying, when you say sister of Aaron or you say brother of. It's loosely like you're saying, oh, daughter of Aaron, or, you know, daughter. No, that's a lie. Here's the first lie. In the Bible, whenever you want to speak of lineage, descendancy, you say daughter of, son of. You don't say sister of or brother of. Okay, be careful of this lie. Need you to listen. Class is beyond. Kitty Lason, good to see you, sister. Blank, you are a dirty little whore. Blank, check. You're a son of a whore, the whore of Babylon. Your father's the devil. And so shut your pie hole before I get the shi on your mother again, because I know she loved doing muta, because you are a little whore. Okay? Blank. I know you're upset because your mother has a speech impediment, you son of a spiritual whore. So hope you're happy now. Now return to your vomit, you little dumb bastard. No disrespect to bastards, they're better than you. All right, don't you love the fact I'm politically incorrect? I love it. If you don't love it, get used to it. You love it, baby. You live. On my heart. Zappy, you get rid of a jinn by getting rid of yourself. Go to Mecca, drink some Zemzem water. All right, anyway, we got some more on telling me, how do I get rid of a jinn? Go to Mecca and drink some Zemzem water. Catholic Defender, I don't know if you're Arthur, but you misrepresented the facts. Stop defending Catholic faith until you get your facts straight. All right, anyway, we ready now? Let me refute this lie. Are you ready? You'll not find a single verse in the Bible where, when you want to speak of lineage, descendancy. Like if you want to talk about, yet you are a descendant of David, where you'll say brother of David. No, you say son of David, son of Abraham, daughter of Abraham, daughter of Sarah, daughter of Aaron. You with me there? You understand? That's a lie. He's lying. Even in the Quran, you'll not find the term sister or brother of used for descendancy. It'll be used for someone who's a member of the tribe. Keep that in mind. So they'll say the brother of Thamud, meaning a member of the tribe. A member of the tribe. Keep this in mind because it's going to bury him in his fake book. Keep that in mind because he's a wicked deceiver.
Children of Israel, sons of God, sons children of man.
See? Children of Israel, not all brothers of Israel, you moron. When the term brother of Israel is used, it's referring to a nation outside of Israel that's contemporary with the Israelites, and they're related. Like when God says to Moses, Deuteronomy 2:48, you're about to go and cross over the land of Esau, the Edomites, your brothers. The Edomites, your brothers. They're contemporary brothers to the Israelites. Why? Because they're the sons of Esau, the twin brother of Jacob, who's the ancestor of Israel. He's lying. Lying. Keep that in mind.
Things like that. No, they're usually not used literally. But the second thing, and this is what got their dander up, was that, all right, fine. If a person, like an atheist, made that remark, they would tolerate.
Look at this guy.
But it shouldn't have come from a Christian.
Why?
You saw or a Jew.
Why?
Or no, let me put it this way. Certainly not a Jew, but definitely not a Christian.
Why?
And the reason is because if you read the New Testament and you're open to Luke, you see Elizabeth, Mary's cousin, as I mentioned a second ago, being called the daughter of Aaron.
Did you catch it? When you want to talk about being a descendant of someone from their line, you say daughter of Aaron, not sister of Aaron. But he didn't give you the full facts because he's a son of Satan. Remember, Allah is a deceiver. All of the Quran is Satan. Muhammad is a son of Satan. That's why we're exposing them. That's why they hate us. Because we have the truth. Our God is the truth. The Bible is true. And they follow Satan. Father of lies. Daughter of Aaron, not sister Aaron, but now watch how he tries to get away from it.
And Mary is her cousin. So why do they use one standard to interpret the Quran and another standard to interpret their own scripture? Well, the Christian would argue, if you look throughout the rest of the Bible, it's very clear that they're not contemporaries. The Muslim would say the same thing about the Quran. There's no
where? Where in the Quran does it say Mary and Aaron are not contemporaries? You see what he did? See what he did again? Watch here. Listen to this argument. I'm going to go back. Listen to it. Because it's going to be his janazah, the burial, like the Lord buried his prophet under his feet. Pay attention again.
Christian would argue, if you look throughout the rest of the Bible, it's very clear that they're not contemporaries. The Muslim would say the same thing about the Quran. There's no indication in the Quran that they're contemporaries.
Where'd you get that from? Here's my challenge to Jeffrey Lange. I hope the Lord will deliver into my hands and I debate you. Here's my challenge to Jeffrey Lange and all the Muslims. Show me anywhere in the Quran where the Quran testifies that Jesus's mother was not a contemporary of Moses and Aaron. See what they did again? This is why you Christians have to learn how to defend your faith and how to destroy Islam. They are presupposing the biblical narrative and taking the Bible as the foundation to understand these stories in the Quran, or they're consulting later history written by Muslims who, because of their conversations with Jews and Christians, are filling the gaps in the Quran and who are learning from Jewish and Christian authorities and or sources the history behind these events. Okay, so what am I saying? You need to pay attention to this, okay? If you just straight up read the Quran, you cannot tell me when Jesus was born, when Moses was born, where Jesus was born, and whether Mary, Aaron, and Moses were not contemporaries. You can't show me that. You can't show me that. Do you know that? You can't show me that? I'm not lying. Here's my challenge. Show me where it says Mary was born considerably later than Moses and Aaron. Show it to me. I want to see the proof. Don't assume it. Don't read my Bible into your Quran, because my Bible exposes your Quran and shows that your Quran is a satanic counterfeit from the pit of hell. And don't read later Islamic tradition, which again needed the Bible and Jewish Christian tradition to explain the stupidity, incoherency, unintelligibility of your book. Okay? Everyone got it? Everyone with me there? Sorry, guys. Sometimes I walk around. This is why I like, you know, live streaming, because I can sit on my couch and relax. I'm not as young as Ed Van Halen looks. Everyone got that point? How does he know Aaron and Miriam are not contemporaries? Where do you get that from? Where do you get that from? See what he's doing? Whereas we know the history of these events in the Bible, because the Bible itself is an historical record, collection of historical records that even give you names of certain rulers or even months and years by which we can know when these events took place. So therefore, to compare Luke 1:5, where it says that Elizabeth is one of the daughters of Aaron, which is written at the time of Pilate, and then Luke even gives you the rulers so you can approximate the time of these events, right? That we know that she's coming about 1,200, if not 1,400 years after Aaron, and therefore it's saying she's a descendant of Aaron. And even the term daughter of Aaron is not the same as sister of Aaron. Where does the Bible say sister of Aaron when referring to descendant of Aaron? Where? See why I can't stand these Muslims? Remember, the kind of God you serve will impact the kind of person you'll be. So if Allah is a deceiver and a liar and a rapist and a murderer, that's how you're going to be. And this garbage can went from being an atheist to following Satan, whom he thinks is God, defending a pedophile prophet.
Quite the opposite. The Muslim would argue that actually the description in the Quran is even more accurate if we accept the description in the Bible.
Oh.
Because if Elizabeth, Mary's cousin, is a direct descendant of Aaron, then she should probably be called in the Middle East a daughter of Aaron. Mary is not a direct descendant. She's once removed.
She's once removed. You see what a stupid guy this guy is? This guy is so stupid he makes Muhammad intelligent. He's saying, see, Mary's not a direct descendant of Aaron. She's once removed. What the hell does that mean? If she's not a descendant of Aaron, she's once removed. Therefore, she can't be called even a sister of Aaron, because in biblical language, that expression is not used even for those related to a particular tribe or a particular line. What is this guy talking about? You understand? You see what he's saying? See, it's probably more accurate to say that Mary is a sister of Aaron because she's not a direct descendant of Aaron like Elizabeth is. She's once removed. What has that got to do with calling her sister of Aaron? If she is not a direct descendant, you don't call her sister of Aaron because the expression sister of, brother of, is not used for lineage, descendancy, or the fact that she's related to Aaron. You'll use brother of, sister of, for someone who's your contemporary. You understand the point? You can say of your cousin, my brother, my sister, if you are contemporaries, but you don't call someone sister of Aaron if somehow her line is not directly connected to Aaron's line. What is this guy talking about? Do you get my point? I want you to understand what a wicked liar he is, and he didn't give you the full orb picture of the Quran. Because the Quran doesn't just say she's a sister of Aaron. I'm going to show you what else she says that this coward did not mention. Okay?
So she cannot be called a daughter of Aaron. If the Quran called her a daughter of Aaron, it would be a mistake.
And made a worse mistake by calling her the sister of Aaron, you moron.
At least if we accept the version in the Bible, because she's not a direct descendant. She's once removed. She's a member of the family of Aaron.
Now, you see how stupid this guy is? You're a member of the family of Aaron. Well, if you're a member of the family of Aaron, then that means you are of the family of Aaron, and therefore you're a descendant of Aaron, and therefore you're a daughter of Aaron. See how stupid this guy is? Because what makes her a member of the family of Aaron? That means someone in her family is from the line of Aaron, right? He can't say she married into the family of Aaron because she's a virgin. She has no husband. And even Joseph is not of the line of Aaron. So what makes her a member of the family of Aaron? Well, if you tell me that, well, maybe her mother married a descendant of Aaron, well, then that makes her a descendant of Aaron, you idiot. See? But watch what I'm going to do to him. I just want you to see his nonsense.
Use a Middle Eastern terminology. She should not be called a daughter. It's more proper and more precise to call her a sister of Aaron. A member of the family, a descendant, but not a direct descendant.
Notice, a descendant, not what in the world is this guy talking about? Is he on drugs? If you're a descendant of Aaron, then you are the family of Aaron, so you are a daughter of Aaron. What are you talking about, dude? But wait, watch his burial.
In any case, the Muslims were very unimpressed by that. Muslim scholars were very unimpressed by that that remark. And that's the strongest one I've ever come across with. Maybe.
You see what a pathetic, effeminate, dishonest, wicked, lying Mohammedan he is? May the Lord rebuke him and expose him until he repents. Now let's go for the burial. Are you ready for the burial? Are you guys ready for the burial? Because he did not give you the full picture. He did not give you the full picture. So you guys ready for the burial? He did not give you the full picture. Even though I ate a lot, dude, still, man, I'm fine, dude. Fine. No, I'm just kidding. All right, let's go. Let me get there. Let's go to the article, shall we? Muhammad Rajim. Run to the moon. Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Muhammad Rajim. Here you go. Let's go. All right. Let me show you what he did not give you. Okay. Let me show you what he did not show you. Are you aware that the Quran says Maryam, Arabic for Mary, the mother of Jesus, is not only the sister of Aaron, she is the daughter of Imran, and her mother is the wife of Imran. See, this is the part he didn't tell you. This is the part he did not tell you. You ready? Let me now show you what the Quran actually says. The Quran says, Maryam, the mother of Jesus, her mother is the wife of Imran. Maryam is the daughter of Imran and sister of Aaron. Now, I want him to tap dance around this one. What do I mean? Let's go to chapter 66, verse 12. And Maryam, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her private sexual part. It's all in the article. It's in the description box. So we introduced therein out of our spirit. And she testified to the truth of the statements of her nourisher, sustainer, and his writings. And she happened to be out of those who are content. Chapter 66:12. Do you see who her father is? Imran. Keep that in mind. Daughter of Imran. 66:12 of the Quran. What about her mother? Chapter 3, verse 35-36. Who is her mother? Remember when the wife of Imran, wife of Imran. And who's the wife of Imran? The mother, Mary, Maryam, said, "Oh my Lord, I have vowed to you what the child that is in my womb to be dedicated for your services, free from all worldly work, to serve your place of worship. So accept this from me. Verily, you are the all-hear, the all-knowing." Then when she delivered her child, Maryam, Mary, she said, "Oh, my Lord, I've delivered a female child, and Allah knew better what she delivered. And the male is not like the female, and I've named her Maryam." All right, catch it. The wife of Imran gave birth to Maryam, Imran's daughter. That's why she's called daughter of Imran. "And I seek refuge with you for her and for offspring from Shaitan, the outcast." So she's the daughter of Imran, her mother is the wife of Imran, and she's the sister of Aaron. Chapter 19, 27, 28. Then carrying the baby in her lap, she came to her people. They said, "Oh, Maryam, Mary, surely you brought quite an amazing thing. Oh, sister of Aaron, Harun, ya ukhta Harun. Neither was your father a bad man, nor was your mother an unchaste woman." Now, you see what the coward did not tell you? She's not just called the sister of Aaron. She's the daughter of Imran, and her mother is the wife of Imran, and the sister of Aaron. Well, let's see who that is. Exodus 15, 20. Then Maryam, the prophetess, the sister of Aaron. Damn. Exodus 15, 20. Maryam, Miriam in Hebrew, Maryam in Arabic, sister of Aaron, took a timbrel in her hand, and all the women went out after with timbrels and dancing. Damn. That sure sounds like chapter 19, 28 of the Quran, where Maryam is said to be sister of Aaron. But wait. Who's her father? Numbers 26:59. The name of Amram's wife. Damn. Miriam, the sister of Aaron, is the daughter of Amram. Was Jochebed, the daughter of Levi, who was born to Levi in Egypt. And she bore to Amram, Aaron, and Moses, and Miriam, their sister. Hold on. Miriam, the mother of Jesus, she's the daughter of Imran, and Maryam, the sister of Moses, she's the daughter of Amram, and Maryam's mother in the Quran is the wife of Imran, and Maryam, the sister of Moses, her mother is the wife of Amram. 1 Chronicles 6:3. See what he did not tell you? You see what he didn't show you? 1 Chronicles 6:3. The children of Amram, Aaron, Moses, and Miriam, the sons of Aaron, Nadab, Abihu, Eleazar, and Ithamar. The only Miriam, sister of Aaron, daughter of Imran, or Amram, is the sister of Moses. The mother of Jesus did not have a father named Imran, Amram, nor did she have a brother named Aaron. Nor was she a descendant of Aaron. The only Maryam, sister of Aaron, daughter of Imran, whose mother was the wife of Imran, is Maryam, the sister of Moses, the daughter of Amram. See it? Did it sink in before I move on? Because I got more. Vishal, keep changing subject and must make sure you're the chosen one to be blocked. Distract me again, brother. Vishal, focus, man, before I send you out of here. All right, now, you want to see another embarrassment? When we go to the Muslim expositors, they record a conversation between a Jewish convert to Islam named Ka'b al-Akhbar, where he tells Aisha, the wife of Muhammad, there's a mistake in the Quran because it says Mary, the mother of Jesus, is the sister of Aaron, which means she's the sister of Moses, but they're centuries apart. And here is the tradition. This comes from Ibn Kathir, but you got to read in Arabic. This part they did not include in the abridged version. Watch here. Okay. This is Ibn Kathir's exposition of chapter 19, verse 28 in Arabic. Watch the embarrassment. You ready? Watch. We're going to have fun with this guy, this wicked liar. Make this go viral and call him out. Say, you wicked liar. Ibn Kathir. It was narrated from Ibn Jarir, narrated from Yaqub, narrated from Ibn Ulaya, narrated from Sayyid Ibn Abi Sadaqa, narrated from Muhammad Ibn Sirin, who stated that he was told that Ka'b, he's Jewish. Remember, he's a Jew, right? Remember what the city had said? Jews and Christians shouldn't bring this up. Said, the verse that reads, O sister of Harun, does not refer to Aaron, the brother of Moses. Can't. So he knows his history. Look what Aisha said. Guys, you catch it? Look at the embarrassment. Look at this. He's saying, hey, Aisha, the sister of Aaron, Mary being the mother of Jesus, being called the sister of Aaron, that can't be the sister of Moses. Look what Aisha said. Aisha replied to Ka'b, you have lied. Damn. Aisha actually thought that Mary, Jesus' mother, was the sister of Moses. Because when Ka'b says that can't be the case, she goes, you're a liar, Ka'b. She is the sister of Moses. See it? See? But then he says, now he even gets the centuries wrong. Ka'b responded, O mother of the believers, if the prophet has said, hey, if Muhammad said it, and he's more knowledgeable, then this is what he related. Besides, I find the difference in time between them to be 600 years. No, actually, more like 1,400 years. He said that she remained silent. When he said that, she got embarrassed and she shut up. Do you understand that even at the time of Muhammad and his companions, there were Jews and Christians saying, hey, this is a joke here. Dude, what are you talking about? Mary, the mother of Christ, sister of Aaron, daughter of Imran, that makes her the sister of Moses. What are you talking about? They were already using this to embarrass Muhammad and his companions. See it? All right. Watch here. Look what also we find. This comes from want to show you here? Sorry. That's actually Ibn Kathir again. People comment. Okay, let me see this. Qurtubi. This is Al-Qurtubi. He narrated the same tradition. Now, I'm giving you the Arabic. So, Al-Qurtubi narrates another report. You guys read Arabic and see it. Al-Qurtubi, look what he says. The people of commentary and interpretation have differed on the reason why it was said, O sister of Harun. They're like debating. They can't even figure out why she called the sister of Aaron. And who this Harun was that Allah mentioned. It was narrated by Ibn Hamid, narrated by Al-Hakim, Ibn Bashir, narrated by Amr, narrated by Simak Ibn Harb, narrated by Al-Qama Ibn Wail, narrated by Al-Mughayra Ibn Shubba, who said, the Prophet sent me, watch, look at embarrassment, to fetch some of his needs from the people in Najran. These were Christians. He went to Christians in Najran who said, doesn't your prophet claim that Harun, the brother of Miriam, is the brother of Moses? I did not know how to respond to them. You caught it? They got stumped. So now Christians are saying, hey, guy, your prophet says Mary is the sister of Aaron, who's the brother of Moses. You're telling me Moses is Jesus' uncle? And look what he said. I did not know how to respond to them. Until I returned to the Prophet. Now watch his lie. I related to him all that was said, and he replied, they used to name themselves after the names of those who came before them. Now this, here again either means that she's being named after Aaron to connect her with Aaron. Well, that's a lie. You don't name someone the sister of Aaron if you're trying to show a connection between her and Aaron. Or it means, or Muhammad means, that Mary had a brother and they named her brother after Aaron. That too is a lie because Jesus did not have any uncle whose name was Aaron. Either way, this is a lie. And either way, it destroys Muhammad, his Quran, and his God. You want me there? So if Muhammad meant, yeah, people would be named after famous people, renowned people, righteous people, prophetic figures. Well, no, you'll not find a single shred of evidence in the Bible where someone will be called the sister of Aaron, sister of Moses, sister of Abraham to show a connection. That's lie number one. But if he meant, yeah, well, they would name their children after famous prophetic righteous figures, that's a lie as well because Mary had no brother named Aaron. In point of fact, I don't know if you know, if you Christians know this, the oldest, the earliest traditions on the Blessed Mother, our Lord, was that her parents did not have children because her mother was barren, could not conceive, and that God miraculously caused Mary's mother, Anna, to conceive in her old age. So she had no brother. The oldest, earliest tradition, as far back as you can trace it, like the Protoevangelium of James the Lesser, the earliest Christian tradition states that Mary's parents, and her mother's name is Hannah or Anna. That's why you have feast days, if you're Orthodox and Catholics, to Saint Anne, Anna, Mary's mother. Because the earliest tradition says her mother's name was Hannah, in Hebrew, Anna. Says she was barren, and it was only in old age that God caused her to conceive miraculously. Right? You guys know, Orthodox and Catholics, what is the name of the Blessed Mother? What is the name of the Blessed Mother's mother, her mother, the grandmother of our Lord from his mother's side? Yep, exactly. The oldest tradition, and don't take my word for it, go look it up. Saint Anna. Anna, Hannah in Hebrew. And what does the oldest tradition? It comes from the first century, because why? Protoevangelium of James the Lesser, though a second century work, is based on earlier traditions. And what does the oldest tradition say? Mary's parents could not have children because her mother was barren, and only later in age, as a miracle, she conceived and gave birth to the Holy Virgin, the Theotokos. So how can Mary have a brother named Aaron when Mary had no brothers? And why would she be named after Aaron to show a connection when she's not connected to Aaron, and you don't say sister of Aaron if you want to show a connection? You see how easy it is to destroy this religion? Because it's a joke. Everyone got it? Before you move on, I guess this guy, Memphis Teddy, wants me to send him to Tennessee. What has that got to do with you being Catholic? I said Catholic Orthodox, this is the oldest tradition. But that's why you wouldn't know about this, because you're a Protestant. You're ignorant of your history. Everyone got it? Before I move on? Okay, now let's read the rest of the narration. Ready? Here it is. So that's a lie. You see how Muhammad embarrassed? Are you catching The tradition meaning Muhammad got his companions embarrassed. Christians were embarrassing Muhammad and his companions, saying, wait, you're saying Mary, the mother of Christ, is sister of Aaron, who's the brother of Moses? What are you, nuts? And even Ka'b al-Ahbar, a Jew, telling Aisha, Mary, the sister of Aaron, that can't be the Aaron, the brother of Moses. She goes, you lied. You lied. Right here. Aisha replied to Ka'b, you have lied. No, your God lied and your prophet lied. All right, but now let's read the rest of it. Others said that Harun referred to as the brother of Moses, and Maryam was classified as his sister, for she is a descendant of his son. Now watch how this just buried this liar. If she's a descendant of Aaron's son, then that would make her a daughter of Aaron, not a sister of Aaron. See the lie? It was narrated by Musa, narrated by Amr, narrated by Asbat, narrated by Al-Suddi, who said regarding, O sister of Harun, that Maryam was a descendant of the tribe of Harun, the brother of Moses, Tabari. You see now why you just destroyed this religion? When you want to talk about descendancy, you don't say sister of David, brother of David, sister of Abraham. You say son of David, daughter of David, son of Abraham, daughter of Abraham. So even if she was a descendant of Harun, you don't say sister of Harun. You see what Muhammad did? He humiliated the Muslims because they don't know how to respond to this. Do you know that? I got more. So you see, he didn't give you the complete argument. And notice what I say here in the article. Notice that it was the Christians and Jews who knew the scriptures and knew the biblical expressions that caught this egregious blunder on Muhammad's part. They saw that the expression sister of Aaron could only mean that Muhammad erroneously confused Jesus' mother with Moses' sister. There you go. But let's go a little deeper, shall we? Let's go to this article here. This too is one of my articles. So the argument isn't that she's called sister of Aaron only. That's part of the argument. The man did not give you the full argument. She's not only called sister of Aaron, she's called the daughter of Imran, and her mother is the wife of Imran. So remember the argument. Do not let them deceive you and lie. We're not simply basing it on Maryam, the mother of Jesus, being called sister of Aaron. We're basing it on her being called daughter of Imran and her mother, the wife of Imran, and sister of Aaron. And I give it to you again, the articles, chapter 3, verse 35, 36, chapter 19, 27, 28, chapter 66, 12, because the only Maryam, who had a brother named Aaron, whose father's name was Imran, even though Quran says Imran, is the sister of Moses. Here it is again. The children of Imran, Aaron, Moses, and Miriam. 1 Chronicles 6, 3. The name of Amram's wife was Jochebed, daughter of Levi, who was born of Levi to Levi in Egypt. And to Amram, she bore Aaron and Moses and their sister Miriam. Okay, hold on. So wait, she is the Mary of the Quran. The mother of Jesus is Imran's daughter. She's the sister of Aaron, and her mother is the wife of Imran. And lo and behold, guess what that Mary, sister of Aaron, is called? Sister of Moses is called. Their sister, Miriam. Whose sister? Aaron, Moses. She's called the sister of Aaron. Exodus 15, 20. Do you guys see this is irrefutable? There is no way a Muslim can escape. This is burial. This proves the fraud of the Quran. The Quran is a joke. Right? And elsewhere, this Miriam is grouped with Moses and Aaron, like Micah 6, 4. I set before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. Numbers 12, Miriam and Aaron spoke against Moses. Moses to Aaron and Miriam. You get it? Okay, but let's go into a little more detail. I gave you this hadith already, but watch here. Let's go back. This actually, where did I quote this from? Interesting. Yep, and this is from Al-Tabri. And the other one I quoted Qurtubi. This is Al-Tabri. So Qurtubi, Tabri, Ibn Kathir, quote these embarrassing narrations. But now watch here. I'm going to destroy the lie that sister of, brother of, can be used to show lineage and connection. Lie. It's all in this article. Because when the Bible wants to describe that you are a descendant of someone, of a household or a tribe, what does it use? Daughter of, right? Daughter of, son of, daughter of, son of, not brother of, not sister of. So let's go here now. Watch here. Here you go. Let's go. Let's watch here. Be patient with me, man. Here you go. Luke 1:5. In the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the division of Abijah, and he had a wife from the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth, not sister of Aaron. Luke 13:16. And not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, not sister of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath day. Luke 13:16. Luke 19:9. And Jesus said to him, today salvation has come to this house, since he also is a son of Abraham, not a brother of Abraham. Are you catching how you're destroying the lies? Because this is a huge blunder, a huge embarrassment. And that's why even the Christians and the Jews at the time, Muhammad and his companions, use this as an example of showing why Muhammad is a fraud. This is an ancient argument, folks. This is an argument used by Jews and Christians, according to Muslim sources, against Muhammad and his followers. Learn this argument. Here, Sahih Muslim, book 25, number 5326. Mughayra bin Shubba reported, when I came to Najran, they, the Christian Najran, asked me, you read, O sister of Aaron, you call Jesus' mother, sister of Aaron, in the Quran, whereas Moses was born much before Jesus. Did you catch it? Arabs who know the Arabic language, because these are Arabic Christians, right? They know Arabic, right? These are Arabic Christians. They know Arabic, right? Everyone got it? So here are Arabs who are Arabic Christians who know Arabic expressions, and they read sister of Aaron, and they took that to mean, oh, so Jesus' mother is the sister of Moses? How? When Moses was born much before Jesus. When I came back to Allah's messenger, I asked him about that, whereupon he said, the people of the old age used to give names to their persons after names of apostles and pious persons that had gone before them. We already destroyed that lie. She had no brother named Aaron, or a brother of Mary was named after Aaron, the brother of Moses. Everyone got it? I can't move on if you're not getting these arguments, folks. You see, the real miracle is that people think the Quran is a miracle. It's a joke. All right? And now, let me shock you a little more. Are you aware that according to the Quran, are you aware that, according to Muslim sources, even Muslim sources admit Mary was a descendant of David of the tribe of Judah. She was not a Levite. This goes into this article. Let's go through here. Let me show you. If you read my article, I go out of my way to show Jesus is a physical descendant of David from the tribe of Judah, and he had no affiliation with Aaron and the tribe of Levi. How do we know? Hebrews 7:14. When talking about Levitical priests from the line of Aaron, in contrast to Christ, Hebrews 7:14, for it is clear that our Lord descended from Judah. He's not from Levi. And in regard to that tribe, Moses said nothing about priests. Revelation 5:5, the line of the tribe of Judah, right? The root of David. And here are sources, early Christian sources like Ignatius, who tells you that Jesus is the seed of David from his mother Mary. Here, for our God, Jesus Christ, was, according to the appointment of God, conceived in the womb by Mary of the seed of David by the Holy Spirit. Now, Ignatius knows Jesus is born of the Virgin, no sex, by the Spirit. How then could he be of the seed of David if Mary gave birth to him as a virgin? Because he knew, like we know, Mary gave to Jesus his lineage, his human nature, his physical body, right? His descendancy from Abraham, Judah, and David. He is a physical seed of David because of his mother being a daughter of David. Everyone got it? No, they won't say that, Marco. No, they'll tell you she may have had a brother named Aaron, and she has some connection to Moses. Not that Moses was her cousin. Now watch here. I'm going to go into the details. Learn these arguments, folks. I promise you, you're going to humiliate Muslims. Now, they'll try to tell you, but hold on. Isn't Elizabeth called Mary's relative? Luke 1:36. Gabriel says to the Blessed Mother, the Holy Virgin Theotokos, even Elizabeth, your relative, Sungenis is going to have a child in her old age. Well, hold on. Elizabeth is a daughter of Aaron, Luke 1:5. Well, if she's related to Mary, then does that mean Mary has some connection to Aaron? No. Do you know why? Now, here's how you destroy this argument. Even though Elizabeth is related to Mary, that doesn't mean because Mary has any connection with Aaron. You know why? Because the Old Testament says that Levitical priests, Aaron and his sons, could marry virgins from any of the tribes. In other words, the reason why Elizabeth would be related to Aaron is because though her father is a descendant of Aaron, her mother would have been a descendant of David, and from her mother's side, she'd be related to Mary. Okay, do you understand the argument? Don't let them deceive you. Okay? Don't let them deceive you. All the refutations to all their lies are in the articles. Pay attention, Katerina. The Lord bless you and you succeed. When you make money, give 20% to my ministry. Don't be hoarding it. Okay. Levitical priests were allowed to marry virgins from any of the tribes. Let me prove it. Leviticus 21:13 and 14. The woman he marries must be a virgin. He must not marry one. This is the Levitical priest, son of Aaron. A divorced woman, or a woman defiled by prostitution, but only a virgin from his own people. Notice, from among the Israelites. Doesn't say she has to be a descendant of Aaron. And here, Ezekiel 44:22. Okay, everyone getting this? You're learning, guys. Give me feedback. You got to learn this argument. Ezekiel 44:22. They shall not marry a widow or a divorced woman. Talking about Levitical priests, the descendants of Aaron, but only virgins of the offspring of the house of Israel, or a widow who's the widow of a priest. Okay, so if someone asks you, how is Elizabeth related to the Blessed Mother when Elizabeth is a daughter of Aaron? Because of the fact that Elizabeth's father would be a son of Aaron, descendant of Aaron, but Elizabeth's mother would be from Judah, from the line of David, and from her mother's side, she'd be related to Mary. Do you understand now? Do you understand? And here's an example of it. The Holy Bible also provides an example of a priest who had married a woman from Judea and was actually the descendant of King David. So here's an Aaronic priest whose wife was a descendant of David. We got it now? Are you learning? Guys, I'm doing it for your benefit. Do you understand that Elizabeth's mother would have been a descendant of David and her mother would be related to Mary? Because Elizabeth's father would be a physical descendant of David and he could marry a virgin from the line of David. Sinking in, guys, or no? Did I put you to sleep? All right, now here's the example. 2 Chronicles 22, 10, 11. A priest, a son of Aaron, married to a daughter of David from the tribe of Judah. Here, 2 Chronicles 22, 10 to 11. Now when Athaliah, the mother of Ahaziah, saw that her son was dead, she arose and destroyed all the royal family of the house of Judah. But Jehoshabeath, the daughter of the king. Well, if she's the daughter of the king is a son of David, descendant of David. That means she's a descendant of David. The daughter of the king took Joash, the son of Ahaziah, right? And stole him away from among the king's sons, were about to be put to death, and she put him and his nurse in a bedroom. Then Jehoshabeath, the daughter of King Jehoram, who was a physical descendant of David, and wife of Jehoiada the priest. Did you catch it? Because she was a sister of Ahaziah, hid him from Athaliah so that she did not put him to death. Did you catch it? Jehoshabeath is a physical descendant of David because her father, King Jehoram, can only be king if he's a descendant of David. But her husband was a Levitical priest, a descendant of Aaron. Yep, Katerina. Everyone got it? Mary had no Levitical blood in her. If we follow the sources, and we don't believe the Bible contradicts, Mary was physically descended from David of the tribe of Judah, from her father and mother's side. It would have been Elizabeth's mother who would have been a descendant of David, and from his mother's side, related to Mary, because Elizabeth's mother could be married to a physical descendant of Aaron, right? A priest. All right? You're burying the Quran. And here are other sources confirming Mary was not a Levite, was not from Aaron's bloodline. Here, the Gospel of the Nativity of Mary. Some of the URLs may be defunct. Here it is. The Blessed and Glorious Ever Virgin Mary sprung from the royal stock and family of David. See it? What about the Protoevangelium of James that relies on first century traditions? And in this book, we're told that Mary's mother, Hannah, and her father were old, and Hannah was barren and conceived Mary miraculously. Okay, chapter 10. And there was a council of the priests saying, let us make a veil for the temple of the Lord. Now watch. Who is Mary? And the priest said, call to me the undefiled virgins of the family of David. Virgins from whose line? David. Whose line, folks? David, right? Everyone getting it? And who's listed among these undefiled virgins committed to the temple from the line of David? And the officers went away and sought and found seven virgins. And the priest remembered the child Mary, that she was of the family of David and undefiled before God. What about Muslim scholars? What do they say? You ready? And that's it. You just destroyed Islam, folks. And Lord willing, I'll try to be on later. Here it is. This comes from Tariq al-Tabari, the history of al-Tabari, volume 4, The Ancient Kingdom, translated by Moshe Perlman, pages 103, 104. Okay. Here you have Tabari linking Jesus' mother to David. He even cites the genealogy of Joseph found in Matthew's gospel. So I'm going to skip this part because he's giving you Joseph's lineage. But now, according to Tabari, here's Mary's line. Catch it. Mary's line. According to Ibn Humayyad, Salama ibn Ishaq, as far as I can learn from her lineage, well, where do you think he learned it from? Christians. Mary was the daughter of Imran. No, she wasn't. Does anyone know what the name of Mary's father is? It wasn't Imran. That's a lie. But anyway, look at her lineage. Daughter of Imran, bin Josiah, bin Amon, bin Manasseh, bin Hezekiah, bin Ahaziah, bin Jotham, bin Azariah, bin Amaziah, bin Joash, bin Ahaziah, bin Joram, bin Jehoshaphat, bin Asa, bin Abijah, bin Rehoboam, bin Solomon. See? Mary is physically descended from Solomon. And yes, the name of Mary's father in the oldest tradition, going back to the first century, her father's name was Joachim, not Imran. Joachim, not Imran. But hold on. Here's another source, a Muslim source. Aliyah Schleifer wrote a book, Mary, the Blessed Virgin of Islam, pages 22 to 23. Okay. Quote, she's a Muslima. She wrote a book on Mary from the Muslim perspective. Quote, look what she says. The Quran informs us that the father Mary was named Imran, and the classical Muslim scholars unanimously accept. Did you hear it? Unanimous. No disagreements among them, even though they contradict themselves, that she was from the line of the prophet David. Damn. Differences of opinion emerge, however, over the intervening genealogy, most probably due to a lack of familiarity with such forenames and consequent error in recording them in the Arabic orthography. According to the Spanish exegete Al-Qurtubi, all these differences are mentioned because the prophets and messengers are all descendants one of the other. Now watch what she says. The following genealogy, taking into account orthographic variations, which is attributed to Ibn Ishaq or directly to the prophet's companion, Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas, Muhammad's cousin. Here's Mary's genealogy. Is the most generally accepted. Mary bint Imran, Ibn Yashim, Ibn Misha, Ibn Haskiyah, Ibn Yawish, Ibn Isha, Ibn Yahushafat, Ibn Suleiman, Ibn Dawood. Got it? Although the name of her mother is not supplied in the Quran, it is universally accepted as Hana. See? Muslim tradition says Mary's mother's name is Hana bint Faqud. So they agree her mother's name is Hana. What does Ibn Kathir say? In his commentary on chapter 19, verse 16, Mary, the mother of our Lord, is from what line? But then he contradicts himself elsewhere by saying she's of Aaron because they're confused, because Muhammad confused them. And mentioned the book of Maryam, she was Maryam bint Imran from the family lineage of Dawood. Damn. And Ibn Kathir said, see, you can be a descendant from your mother's side because Jesus was a descendant of David and Abraham and he had no father. So your mother can give you a legitimate lineage. And use Mary as an example. There you go. Everyone got it? They'll tell you they're skipping generations. Folks, there you go. Destruction of Islam. If you study the materials, if you learn the arguments, and you share them correctly, the Muslims can't refute you. So what was the argument? Okay. The argument isn't simply Mary is called, right, the sister of Aaron. See, that's part of the argument. That's part of the argument. All right? Isn't called simply sister of Aaron. That's part of the argument. The actual argument is she's called the sister of Aaron. Sister of Aaron, daughter of Imran, and her mother is the wife of Imran. So let me make some final points before we go on. Here it is again. Let's go back to the article. Some final points before we go on. Here's the actual argument. And then we're going to wrap it up. And Lord willing, I should be back on a little later. Here it is. Chapter 3, verse 35, 36. Remember the wife of Imran. Oh, my Lord, I have vouched to you what the child that is in my womb to be dedicated for your services. She got pregnant by Imran. She gave birth to a daughter. And what did she name her? And I've named her Maryam. So Mary's mother, wife of Imran. Chapter 3, verse 35, 36. Chapter 66, verse 12. And Maryam, the daughter of Imran. Here, she's said to be Imran's daughter. 66, 12. But then, 19, 27, 28. Oh, Maryam, Mary. Oh, sister of Harun, Aaron. Now compare this. The Maryam, the mother of Jesus, daughter of Imran, her mother, wife of Imran, sister of Aaron. Now compare it with Moses' sister. Exodus 15, 20. Then Miriam, the prophetess, the sister of Aaron. Well, that's exactly identical to 1928. Miriam, sister of Aaron. All right. Numbers 26, 59. Who's her father? The name of Amram's wife. Imran in the Arabic Quran. Amram in Hebrew. And his wife bore to Amram Aaron and Moses and Miriam, their sister. So Amram's wife is the mother of Miriam and the mother of Aaron and Moses. So Aaron, Moses, and Miriam are the offspring of Amram. And who gave birth to Miriam? The wife of Imran, making her a daughter of Imran. And 1 Chronicles 6, 3. The children of Amram, Aaron, Moses, and Miriam. So Miriam is the daughter of Amram. Can it be any clearer and irrefutable that the Quran thinks that Miriam, the mother of Isa, Jesus, is the sister of Moses, making Moses Jesus' maternal uncle? And then the Muslim sources confirm, even Jews and Christians use this to shame Muhammad and his companions, like Cobb telling Aisha, hey, Mary, the sister of Aaron, that can't be the brother Moses. What did she say? You're a liar, Cobb. Mary, the sister of Aaron, is the sister of Moses. Really? Well, I see there's a 600-year gap between them. Oops. Oops. Let me make one final point before I finish. You really want to hit this point home? You really want to hit this point home? Well, when you go here to the article here, scroll down. You go to what type of Messiah does the Quran say Jesus happens to be, parts one and part two. So let me get the part relevant here. You're going to see in Islamic tradition, Aaron and Moses, Musa and Harun, the two brothers, they are said to be the sons of who? Watch here. You ready? They are said to be the sons of who? Get ready. Sahih Muslim, book 1, number 317. I passed by Moses bin Imran, the son of Imran. Did you catch it? Mary, the daughter of Imran, Moses, the son of Imran. Sahih Muslim, book one, number 317. How about this one? Commemorating the prophet's rapture and his ascension to his Lord. So when Muhammad is going through the seven heavens, he sees these prophets, and he says to Jibreel, who was this? This is Musa ibn Imran, son of Imran. So Moses' father is Imran. Then later on, this is the man who is beloved among his people, Harun ibn Imran, Aaron, the son of Imran. As they went in, the prophet saw Musa, son of Imran. So wait, Moses, son of Imran. Aaron, his brother, son of Imran. Mary, Maryam, the mother of Jesus, Quran, daughter of Imran, sister of Aaron. Catch it? It's burial, brethren. It's over. This is why even Karen Armstrong, who is very friendly to Islam, not Islamophobe, who wrote a biography of Muhammad that Muslims praised, she, Karen Armstrong, a liberal, admitted in her biography on Muhammad, and the Muslims are praising this biography, by the way, pages 130, 131, and they praise her work on Islam. Look what she says, pages 130, 131. Muhammad's knowledge of scripture was still limited, however. The prophetic figures venerated by the Arabs in their own traditions were put side by side with the prophets of the Bible as though they were equal in status. Indeed, as we have seen, the Quran sees all rightly guided religions as coming from God. Muhammad did not know the chronology in which the scriptural prophets appeared. Ouch! A very friendly scholar to Islam. She used to be a nun. She lost her faith. Muhammad did not know the chronology in which the scriptural prophets appeared. He seems, for example, to have thought that Maryam, the mother of Jesus, was the same as Maryam, the sister of Moses in the Jewish scriptures. Damn! Game over. Game over.